She's deceased now. So I have been trying to learn more about her people as well. But I grew up in my mother's language, and she taught me a lot about doing people and about our relationship to the land. And one very beautiful thing, if you ever go down to Badala or Vika, there's a mountain called Tunga, and the white people say called the there. But that's you know, it means a camel. But Bulaga is actually a woman who goes to the land. And when we see her lying down, she's in the mountain. And she has very big breasts and a very big stomach and legs. And they give birth to the land. And the way that it relates to my father's country is that my father's country goes through until the snowy wall. There's song lines that go through into the snowy mountains. There's a connection between the tribes. And my great-great-grandfather from my mother's side, she is, he is Jack by a mango, and he came from the snowy mountains from Narago. So that is the connection. My father's tribe, they went through a lot of stolen generation business. And when I drew this, I wanted to have a nice little note, a nice one to show because I can make a beautiful system. But then I saw the masking tape and it looked kind of pretty, and I sort of thought, my connections, I'm still connected to these people, even though I don't know them. But the connection is a bit dangerous. It's not very good sometimes. And so I make sure that I have represented that truthfully, because it's not destroyed, it's still there. I mean, that's, I think that's one of the most destroying things about being Aboriginal sometimes. It's not destroyed, it's still there. My family is still in pain, and I am trying to connect with them, but sometimes it's not easy because of colonization. And so that's how easy it was actually gone on in this country. And so that's why, yes, I'm not going to explain the look, but I've seen a cleansing, and I was explaining where I came from for Uncle here and for everyone here. And this is my ancestry.